Okay, well, Alfred Pippin from Granville, you've already said that. I'm 86. My oldest brother, Julian, went into the Army 6 months before I did and told me that it would be good to get in the anti-aircraft artillery because it would be less dangerous. And so I did, and I'm glad I did. And then I went into the Army December the 12th, 1942, and got out in 1945 and I went to Mineral Wells, to the Camp Walters there at Mineral Wells. And then from there I went to Camp Callan, California, down on the West Coast, and I took basic training and then went to El Paso, Fort Bliss, for advanced training and infantry training and searchlights at Fort Bliss and El Paso. And I shipped out to Oahu on a Kotobaru, a Dutch ship, with the Javanese crew. We couldn't understand a word they said. And I shipped out on October to Ulithi in the Caroline Islands group of Micronesia. I was on a small island called Sorlin, about 300 feet wide and a half mile long, and had about 8 acres in it, with seven of us Army guys and about a few hundred sailors. I don't know, maybe 700 or 800 or 1,000, I don't know. But we got along marvelously. We was the only one on the island that had lights at night, because our radios were close to the ocean that it would short our radios out. So we got some plywood and built about a 2 foot square for each one of the radios, and then put two light bulbs in it, and that solved the problem. And we were right on the beach on the seaward side at Sorlin, and at high tide I could lay in my bed and paddle in the water. So we were that close. And there was Ulithi natives there, and they had about seven islands in that group, I believe, the Ulithi group I was, the Caroline Islands, but the Ulithi group. And each group had a king, and this was King, I don't know how you pronounce it, UEG was his name. And he loved to smoke, but he liked to have about 3 cigarettes at a time because they were American. Everybody wanted American cigarettes. And we could get cigarettes for 45 cents a carton, 4.5 cents a pack. But you had to buy Philip Morris to get a Camel or a Lucky Strike. And say we'd get the Philip Morris, and then we'd take them out and toss them in the ocean because we couldn't smoke them, it was too hot. And one of our guys went out to a ship. He got talking to a guy from an aircraft carrier. One of the sailors was a coxswain on a boat that they always carried with them, and said something, eggs come up, and he said that we didn't have any eggs for nearly a year. He said, oh, come on, I'll get you some eggs. And they went out to the aircraft carrier and got 30 dozen and brought them back. We started cooking eggs, and I ate 16 between then and breakfast. And then I went in there and ate breakfast. I was just a kid that I could eat. And later on, we confiscated 115 pounds of round steak, and we cooked that too. And then one of the sailors was on the KP, and he brought us out a 5-pound box of Mother's Cocoa, and another one brought out about 72 pieces of chocolate cake in a pan about this big. And another one brought a case of pet milk. So we had chocolate galore. Is this it? Yeah. And while I was there, I was stung by a Portuguese man of war, and they are very painful. And it started right across there and went up and came under the arm and across this shoulder and down this side. They were about 15 feet long, and they sting like a wasp. And I don't remember ever putting anything on it to stop the burning. I don't know if you could or not,